Friday night, Maction Caravan hits the road to Western New York and the University at Buffalo. They've been to four of the last five NCAA tournaments. Toledo trying to get there for the first time since 1980, and these are two of the top-tier programs in the MAC. Unofficial MAC historian joins us from Indianapolis. His name is Dan Dockett. Jason Benetti here in Chicago. Dan, these two teams since 2013, the most wins in the Mid-American Conference. Nice plant.
Yeah, and it's absolutely amazing what Buffalo has been able to do since coming into the conference in 1998. And then through all kind of probation, they had all kind of things. Reggie Witherspoon came in. He was coaching Erie Community College. He took it over and went to the NCAA tournament. You mentioned Toledo. Toledo and Bowling Green separated by, I don't know, 20, 30, I don't know. Neither have been to the tournament. 80 for Toledo, 68 for Bowling Green.
And here we go. It is Toledo and Buffalo from the MAC and from Alumni Arena. And Ryan Rollins, who's a freshman guard for the Toledo Rockets out of the state of Michigan, as the first two. These are both high-paced teams, and we're going to see a lot of points tonight, Dan.
All right. For you guys that pay attention to these things, and I happen to be one of them, the over-under on this is about 165. That means 83-82. We're going to get up and down, and we're going to shoot a lot of threes, and it's going to be a lot of fun with Maction today.
Well, you got Buffalo, who's got four guys in the starting lineup averaging 13 points a game or more, and Toledo, a very strong three-point shooting team. They are top 30 in Division I, and they get a stuff there to make it 4-0 for Rollins.
Well, this is what you face when you face Toledo. You have to run and cover them at the three-point line. You're so spread out because everybody shoots threes. What happens if you tap patience and drive? Good things happen.
Well, there Javon Graves tried to pass the ball to Laquil Hardnett, who wasn't ready for the pass, and instead they get an open look from three. And Toledo makes it a 4-3 score at this point on that three from Ronaldo Segu, who was a very highly recruited recruit out of Orlando. Man, we're going to see a lot of shots, a lot of possessions, a lot of points in this game tonight. There's a three from Cedric Milner Jr., and he misses. So it's going to be interesting watching the three-point line today because Buffalo's top five in the country in three-point defense as Janathan Williams, one of the stars of this show tonight, has Buffalo's first lead.
You know, Janathan Williams can shoot threes. There's no question about it. But Janathan Williams, if he does that, has patience and goes to the basket, he's going to get 20-25 tonight.
You think that's it? Not 30?
No, he might get 30, actually, but that's a lot. Look at this.
A little slip and a stuff for Milner.
Just a little side ball screen, but on the weak side, Jason, everybody for Buffalo is staying with the shooters outside the three-point line. Shooting has eliminated help, and you see a dunk, layup, drive. Most patient driving team is going to win the game.
Here is Janathan Williams. He is a junior out of Rochester, just down the throughway. He's got that stuffed back at him by JT Shoemate, but perseverance gets him two.
Yeah, that was really good. He just got blocked, let it drop, got it back, and he was at his strong shoulder, so an easy flip shot.
We'll tell you Williams' story throughout the night, but he's from Rochester and a tough part of Rochester, New York, and the Flower City as Toledo turns it over. And there is Todd Kowalczyk in his 11th season with the Toledo Rockets and trying to get him back to the NCAA tournament. They're in position right now as the leaders of the MAC opening play tonight.
And 2000, they had a three go in by Greg Stempen that might have won them a semifinal game and put it into the final, but a timeout was called by the coaching staff, and that was about the best shot Toledo's had, truthfully.
Marion Jackson, who is the leading scorer for Toledo, an extremely talented guard out of Cleveland. This is Janathan Williams, who's denied. And Mbala, the transfer from Texas Tech, has the follow.
I love Mbala. We were talking off air. He is what you want, man. He is big, he's strong, but you know, even more than that, he is willing to go to the backboard, and he tries, I mean, really tries to defend.
Gets you about 10 rebounds a game as that three is too long from Spencer Littleson, who's a 48% three-point shooter.
Yeah, he will not miss another one that badly, maybe all year, that open.
Toledo's cutting hard to the basket, away from the ball. Rollins mishandled. Look at the Buffalo bench celebrating the long defensive possession. Rollins hanging, and he is denied at the rim. Williams the rebound. And that's going to be a carry. Yep. So 9-6 Buffalo over Toledo. 15:41 to go in the first. And there's Jim Weitzel over on the bench for the Buffalo Bulls. Taking over for Nate Oates, but the same kind of open floor, shoot a lot of threes, pace situation.
Yeah, just saw where Nate Oates down in Alabama got himself a three-year contract extension, and Jim Weitzel has. And Agnes Thorpe on the right, terrific, long time coach, just guys that understand offensive basketball. Jim was a terrific coach at Loyola for a lot of years. I had a friend, Ryan Sterling, played for him and really enjoyed him, really good guy.
Well, thank you to all of you watching the A-10 game. Jason Benetti, Dan Dockage for the top two winningest programs in the MAC since 2013. You missed 15 points, but you're going to see a lot more. These are the top two scoring teams in the Mid-American Conference. And you see what Buffalo's done in this series over the last two games. They've averaged a buck seven against Toledo. We may not see defense all night.
We just saw it on the last possession. That was one.
But they weren't here for it. They didn't see it. So we could tell them that they're not going to see.
Well, they were all watching on news. They came over with us. There was one good defensive possession thus far. Here's the setup of the game. If you don't just settle and jack up threes, which both teams will do occasionally because they're very good shooting teams, the team that drives it, plays out of penetration, is going to win this game. The team that gets impatient and jacks up a three is going to lose this game. It's almost as simple as that.
We'll introduce you to the stars in this game in a moment as we lead you up to this weekend. Some big college basketball tomorrow. We'll have Michigan State and Indiana at noon, and then after that, Texas Tech and Kansas in a rematch of a one-point game that we saw earlier this year in Lubbock. And then it's a Sonic Blockbuster Saturday primetime, Virginia and Duke from Cameron Indoor at 8 Eastern time. Anthony Davis clone Jay Huff and the Virginia Cavaliers are on the road to take on the Blue Devils. Full day of college basketball, but as you join us here for this game, keep an eye out for that young man, number 11 in blue. His name is Janathan Williams. He's a junior out of Rochester who stayed home to play college basketball just a little bit down the thruway. He gets Buffalo about 18 points a game, and talking to him this week, he's a young man who, when he was 13 years old, he was playing in a men's league with his dad. Like 30, 35-year-old guys running him up and down the floor. I said, what'd you do? He said, I had the young legs. And so I was the guy that was just on the fast break all the time, running circles around the middle-aged guys. I love that.
I do too.
So we got a couple of really strong offensive ball clubs. Toledo does it from outside the paint quite often. They're one of the top three-point shooting teams in the country, top 30. And that one rims out for Mattia Acunzo. And you said you were watching tape at Toledo earlier this year. They can rim out a three.
I've never seen anything like it, their game against Bowling Green at home. I've never seen more shots go halfway down and pop out. It got to the point where even the announcers in the game are like, you know, this is ridiculous. They rim them out constantly. I'll tell you why. All right, may I?
Please.
I was watching Toledo shoot. A lot of their basketball spins in a globe fashion.
A globular sort of.
Yes.
Side to side.
Yes. Yeah. And that shoots the ball out. A ball spinning, you know, two or three rotations normally, the ball sucks in on the rim and goes in. That one, you just bigger than everybody
there.
Yeah.
I mean, he just carved everybody. But that's really interesting on the physics there, the spin deal. I didn't know we were going to get globe fashion in this early, but that was good stuff.
Well, thank you.
Unofficial
Mac. You
don't
get that just anywhere, pal. You get that in Maction Friday nights.
You do. Unofficial Mac historian Dan Dockett. I was going to call you official, and then I got a buzz in my ear.
Jeremy Guy's the official Mac historian.
Shot clock down to six. They get an open look at three. That won't go down. And Buffalo defensive rebounding to make it one and done for Ronaldo Segu, who was originally recruited by Florida State, as he goes down. And here comes Marion Jackson, the star for Toledo, in transition to line up an open look for three and make it a two-point game as that one goes down for the Rockets and Keyshawn Saunders.
I happened to just catch Jim Weitzel out of the corner of my eye watching the shooter, and as soon as he saw how open Saunders was, he just kind of put his head down like, oh, man.
No. Oh, he went sad. Sad
face. Sad face.
Uh-oh. Javon Graves going to the free throw line, a preseason first team All-MAC player. Buffalo's got a lot of dudes that can score, Dan.
Yeah, they really do. And again, if they don't settle, you know, sometimes you can fall in love. You make a three or two early, next thing you know, you're shooting them. If they don't settle and they continue to drive it, they're going to be fine in this game because they've shown right now that they can get by Toledo on the dribble.
Well, look, Buffalo's won five in a row in this series. You've coached in the MAC. When somebody's got your number like that, sometimes it doesn't matter whether the players have turned over, right?
No, it's really amazing. You know, you feel, and I'm sure that, well, this is every league, really, but, I mean, in the MAC, it is really funny. You get on these runs against teams, or they get on a run against you, and you can't really put your finger on why. And I guarantee you, the why in this game is because Toledo hasn't guarded at all in this series. Look at this.
Oh, what a bounce pass threaded through by Segu. Goodness gracious.
I'll tell you this. You look at the MAC and the guards in the MAC, five of them are first team all-league. Segu was not one of them. The big's better, obviously, in the Big Ten or SEC, Big 12, whatever. But I'm telling you, these guards are absolutely fantastic in this. Always have been.
There's one. Marion Jackson with the find to the corner, and Saunders again. Toledo is a 38% three-point shooting team. That's top 30 in the country.
Well, you got a problem. Because Williams left Saunders second time, and that'll make you crazy as a coach.
Yeah, first time, okay. Second time, stop.
Yeah. First time was transition. Second time, you just ran into help.
Down low, two for Trayvon Fagan, who's been awesome the last two games.
That was terrific by Williams. I mean, Williams sat down, could have shot it. Could have shot it over somebody, but he showed not only unselfishness, but what a great bounce pass.
Akunzo, the freshman, wanted to spin baseline and lost it out of bounds. It is off Buffalo with 12 to shoot. You and I were there, Dan, a couple years ago in Boise when Buffalo took down Arizona. DeAndre Ayton and Arizona showed up as a four seed. Buffalo knocked him out in the first round. Nate Oates got the job in Alabama, and Jim Weitzel took over.
They were terrific. Like, I was sitting in Boise watching that game going, my goodness, is this a good team? Then they ran into a Kentucky team that obviously had about 12 first-round draft choices, a little different deal. But Ayton was the first player picked in the draft.
Yep.
And they went out there and whooped him. I mean, whooped him all day.
He looked uncomfortable all game long.
Yeah.
Little step back for Segu, misses. Oh, defensive rebounding's been a struggle at points for Toledo, and Segu scores for two.
There's the next great guard in the MAC right there. I'm telling you.
Yep.
He has everything you want. What do you want in the MAC guard? You got to be quicker than everybody because that's why you're there. You're little, that means you're quick. You got to be able to shoot it with that quickness, and then you got to have sense, and the kid has real sense.
How do you see that?
It bounce pass, how he jumps going to the rim. When he goes to the rim, timing on things.
Oh, that was a great dish from Saunders. The finish wasn't there. And we head to a timeout. Akunzo is frustrated with himself.
What is it? Fool me once, shame on me. Fool me twice, No, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. They left
Nobody
him twice.
Nobody knows that phrase. Nobody knows that phrase.
I'm out.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Heineken 00. Now you can. So Toledo's made the trip to Buffalo in Western New York, getting some snow as it gets the reputation for. It's a beautiful place, so we love Buffalo. But Toledo is without their director of operations today on the sideline. His name is Jordan Loft, and he and his wife Quincy became parents for the first time last night. Their daughter, Collins Renee, born in Toledo. And you know Jordan very well, Dan.
Yeah, Coach Jordan. He and my son Andrew coming up together. We lived out in Bowling Green, 15 miles south. And Jordan and his dad, John, congratulations to them, man. Jordan was a terrific player at Toledo. A great kid to be around. Mark Donnell, who played at Michigan, was with us, a bunch of other local kids. We just had a blast for a number of years traveling AAU and playing basketball.
He's a dad now.
It's unbelievable. I just want to throw up.
Jonathan Williams has 6 for Buffalo. I like this kid a lot, watching him on tape, 11 for Buffalo.
You know, he reminds me of Justice Suing at Ohio State. Both left-handed, both can go in and out, can get in the lane. Smart, I mean smart basketball players, always making the right play.
I like that comparison. That's good stuff right there.
Yeah, Justice Suing, to me, you're going to see him on Sunday against Michigan. I can't wait for that game. It's going to be terrific. But he is one of the kids, guys, men across the country that could go get 20, 25 for 3 nights in a row in a tournament type thing, and so can Williams.
Top 8 will go to the MAC tournament this year. Toledo trying to be that one seed in Cleveland as we walk up to Champ Week coming up in just a few weeks. That game will be on Saturday the 13th, the final of the MAC. But Buffalo right now, the defending champ 2 years in a row with no tournament last year, as Toledo's getting to the rim but not scoring.
Boy, you're right. They're getting really good looks.
David Nickelberry, no, over the top. Williams, goodness, wow.
Man, that's where I wish I was in the arena. Because in the arena, Jason, he would look like he's 14 feet in the air.
Man. That was ridiculous from Jonathan Williams.
Nice back cut. He couldn't get it. I tell you what, Buffalo's guarding, Jason.
Yeah, they are.
Not there.
Rollins off the shot fake and an open dunk. Yeah, that was not guarding anybody. Milner stuffs it all.
He showed the ball. A little shot fake. Defender went flying into the air, and next thing you know, the whole defense broke down.
This game's going too fast for you to get out the MAC yearbooks, by the way, and start listing people.
I know. If you ever knew me when I was in the MAC, we'll talk about you.
Williams, the miss. Rebound from Milner, who looked like he was going to throw hands if somebody tried to take the rebound from him.
He's a tough kid.
That's what Marion Jackson said to us this week. He said, we feel like the MAC doesn't think we're tough enough, so we got to show up and be tough tonight.
Well, let's be honest. What do people view as toughness, right? Defense. That's what they view. Again, to the rim. Oh, man. Let's watch.
Look at this.
A little delayed, too.
You got a little kick in there.
Kids, don't shot fake with your head. Like, people think, I'm going to lift my head because I'm in a hurry. Take your time. Keep your rear end down. And show the basketball to, at minimum, your nose, at best, to your forehead, and you'll get a willing defender up in the air most times.
But keep if you your just rear show end your down.
Head, keep your rear end down so you don't travel. Lift your rear end, you might travel.
Another offensive rebound, and Williams had it crowbarred away. That was Jonathan Kamagum. And that three is pure from Spencer Littleson, who's an absolute marksman for Toledo.
Man, he set his feet way before he got the ball. He ran into that little choppy to get his feet set. Left foot, right foot, beautiful.
Nice shot fake. Williams on the drive. Rimmed it out. Boy, Toledo's really struggling on the defensive glass so far. Littleson to the baseline. He wanted that shot the whole way, and he canned it.
Yeah, don't let him get going. We're sitting here at our home studios watching warm-up. He was making everything. Like, do not let him get going.
That was insane, though. Like, who goes running to the short corner to get himself an 18-footer?
Nice.
Hard drive.
Sagu's going to be really, really good. I mean, nationally really, really good.
Yep. He got an offer from Florida State in ninth grade. He ended up coming to Buffalo, but he was highly thought of at a very young age, as that's going to be a hard foul against Javon Graves, and free throws coming for Kamagum.
Well, your guy, Littleson, you do not want to get Spencer Littleson. He chopped his feet, stepped in left to right. He knew it was in. I mean, he started backpedaling, and then here he dribbled. Not exactly like you draw it up in a clinic, dribble it from the left to the right, get going to the short corner. Don't let him get going.
All right, so set up all your screens tomorrow and watch ESPN all the way through the day. Michigan State, Indiana, we'll have that for you. Then Texas Tech and Kansas at 2 o'clock. That's Dick Vitale and Bob Wischusen. Auburn, LSU, Louisville, North Carolina. Then Saturday, primetime, Virginia Duke. Jake Bylus and Dan Shulman will have the call of that one. All day, great basketball. And we started off, Dan Dockich, and what have we got, 14 and a half hours? We got Michigan State, Indiana.
Yeah, we do. I can't wait. Michigan State struggling. Oh, man, are they struggling. Indiana, win this one, you're probably in the NCAA tournament. In Assembly Hall, Tom Izzo needs to. I tell you what Tom Izzo said today, or at least he said it in Detroit newspapers. I think it was yesterday. He said, look, players are auditioning. They're auditioning. And you can make the argument.
He can't find a lineup right now.
No, and you know, he's wanting to see who wants to be there, not only at the end of this year, but next year. And Duke, how about Duke without Jalen Johnson? Mm-hmm. How about Duke going into Wake and just destroying them? Interesting stuff going on in college hoops, and tomorrow all day. Don't go anywhere, although I might go ice skating.
You could go ice skating. The pond is frozen over, or your future home is frozen over. Second one good for Kamagum, and it's a three-point game. Look, Virginia, if you haven't seen Virginia in a while, they're, for the most part, with one blip, playing great basketball, and they're shooting the lights out right now.
Yeah, they really are. They have a good, really good shooting team. It's traveling. And then, you know, another team, I was talking to Bill Self about his team, and he made a great point. He goes, Dan, we don't have pros, sure. It doesn't mean we don't have enough to win, and they feel they are so much better now than before in terms of their defense, particularly their ball screen defense. So when you're watching tomorrow, don't discount Kansas against Texas Tech.
Texas Tech hadn't played for a while, about 10 days. We get an offensive foul against Toledo, so a turnover for the Rockets in a very clean game so far, just a grand total of four fouls to this point.
You know, this is one of those games dangerous for Buffalo. Feels like they should be up 7, 8, 9 right now, Jason. It really does. Toledo has given them opportunities by not rebounding and missing shots close.
Buffalo's got 20 of their points from in the paint as Sagu got in there again. Great read by Littleson.
The big Sagu turned it over, and Littleson just, boom!
That Carmine Saguso?
Yes, the big Sagu.
Uh-huh. Littleson, by the way, if Toledo makes the NCAA tournament, Littleson's about to become a star with the hair and the way he plays and all that. Like, he's got star waiting to happen.
I think there's a few of these guys out here, dude. Look, the ball got stuck on top, and then the freshman threw it to his own teammate. That's not what you do. You throw it away from the defense. Or Littleson's going to dunk on the entire city, the Glass City. Oh, wait,
somebody,
it's the Rose City.
Frickers.
They're on the road.
Somebody at Frickers is excited, though, in the Glass City.
Cheering at Tony Paco's. They went up at the bar and started yelling, sign a bun, Littleson.
Are you part of the Toledo Chamber of Commerce?
I love this. I do. I love that city. I do.
Look, I spent many a night at the Park Inn downtown when I was traveling there with the Syracuse Chiefs and hanging out at the Mud Hens games.
I think Toledo, there are some restaurants there on rooftops overlooking the river. Are absolutely fantastic.
I know you're from the Midwest because you said rooftops.
Yeah.
Rooftops.
My wife, a Hall of Famer at Toledo. There will be a picture on camera of my wife. Legendary softball player at Toledo. Took him to the College World Series. The lovely Lee Ross.
Oh, wow! What a drive! Graves cleaving the defense. That was vicious.
Better find him.
Littleson,
you know what he did, Jason?
Short.
He leaned back. He put his feet pushed him backwards, and he was short.
Nickelberry draws a foul. That little lean left it short.
Oh, look at this drive by Graves. Man, anybody that tells you players aren't as good as back in the day, uh-uh. Players back in the day, you had like one on a team that could do this. Now everybody just, whoa.
What was that he did? What was that sound?
I don't know.
He blew. Can't do it again.
Seriously, I mean, guys are bigger, stronger. They shoot better.
So you got no time for people who say, wow, back in the day it was better basketball.
I don't. I'm sorry. I mean, I don't know. You can say it's better basketball if you'd like. But dudes like Graves, the bodies on these kids, no, it's not close.
Buffalo, by the way, is just not a good free throw shooting team at all. They're 316th in the country as Nickelberry goes 1-for-2. But Buffalo is very willing defensively, and they've read the back cuts well so far against Toledo.
Well, in the Bowling Green game, one of the emphases that Bowling Green had was staying down on shot fakes. And if you can combine all this defense with staying down, you're in good shape. Here we go.
Ooh, how about that? The freshman Rollins tied up with Nickelberry. You can tell, right? Buffalo's won 5 in a row in this series. You can tell Toledo's not happy about that, and Buffalo is giving it to him a little.
You know, one of the things I loved about coaching in the MAC is that everybody got along, but everybody disliked each other. I mean, they're longtime rivals. A lot of these players, you know, most of the schools in the MAC are in Michigan or Ohio, and you grew up playing against each other. Buffalo's in there. They start winning, so you dislike them. I mean, the MAC is one of the great, great leagues for rivalries and fun rivalries.
Nickelberry whistled it wide. Marion Jackson looking for his first points, and he does corral it for two. Mbala wrestled it away, and we're going to get an early whistle on that tie-up there. Don't you think? Maybe a little let him play.
Yeah, I did. They've been letting him play pretty good. It's been one of the better officiated games I've watched, truthfully, because they haven't called a bunch of ticky-tack type fouls.
Our officials, Chad Barlow, Ron Taberski, and Bill Eck, veteran officials today, as Williams reels that in and puts it in for two. Strong first half for Janathan Williams.
Yeah, just a simple back screen, and Toledo got caught on it, and a terrific. Williams really went and got the basketball. The last 3 feet of a pass are yours as an offensive player. Go meet it. Williams did. He got a bucket.
Oh, freshman Rollins hurrying to the basket but couldn't finish. And Buffalo loves transition. Stay back, JT. Talk about playing passing lanes. Toledo jumping those big time as two free throws on the way for Graves.
Sagu got lucky right there. That was almost a turnover. He needs to settle down a little bit. He's played well, going to the rim, just handling the ball. He's made some mistakes, but he's a really good player. This is a fun. This is the way basketball should be played in my world.
Well, I'm all for the basketball, but I don't know that anybody wants to live in your world, if we're going to be honest.
It's a good world. It's a really good world.
First free, it's a tough live. First free throw, good. Hey, NBA Saturday primetime presented by AT&T 5G on ABC and the ESPN app. It's an NBA Finals rematch. It is Jimmy Butler And the Heat against LeBron and the Lakers. That's Saturday, 8:30 Eastern time, 5:30 Pacific. Coverage starts 8 Eastern with NBA Countdown. See you there.
I'm starting to work towards LeBron James being the greatest player of all time. It's hard for a guy my age with Michael Jordan. It's hard. I'm starting to work my way there. The longer he plays, what are you going to do? That guy's unbelievable.
And he's still playing with that same authority, too.
Yeah.
Jackson wrapped it around beautifully for Rollins for three.
The help defense did nothing but help on the help. You can't do that. Oh, wow.
Sagoo, no. By the way, Marion Jackson will pass from any angle. We've learned that in the first 17 minutes tonight.
He's the Pat Mahomes of the MAC.
A little bit. Zach Wilson. You know how much I like Zach Wilson at BYU for doing that.
You see what June Jones said today, former coach?
I didn't, but I didn't think June Jones would get in before Wally Szczerbiak tonight.
Said Mac Jones is the best quarterback in the league. There you go.
Oh, a little bank shot for Rollins in Toledo. Javon Graves missed the three. Mbala finds the rebound again. And it's knocked free. Buffalo gets a third chance. Sagoo wide open. Boy, Mbala never stops on the glass.
No, he doesn't. He is a hard playing kid.
Jackson wants to pass. He does on a hard cut from Rollins. They get it back with Milner. And Shumate the rebound. Jackson, yes, for three.
What are you looking for after you get an offensive rebound? You're trying to find the next guy that's set up to knock in a three, and Jackson was perfectly set for that. Tell you this, I've said this for years. Teams that can score. Hey, Sean, myself, Jason Benetti, you know, my wife, whoever. We five of us can get in the 50s. You get in the 80s? Now you're going to eliminate a lot of teams because a lot of teams can't get in the 80s, Sean. And I think that both of these teams, if they get an opportunity, probably one bid league, but if they get an opportunity, I can see them pulling it, you know, a first round upset because they can get in the 80s.
Toledo, I mean, Toledo shoots 38% from three as they get two more down low, Buffalo does. But they also are a very good free throw shooting team. There's a lot of shooting skill on Toledo, and that's scary in the NCAA tournament.
Yeah, and you know what? That's a problem for Buffalo. In this game, this close game, may come down to free throw shooting. Can you make them late? Bad free throw team.
That's a fade for Rollins. Yeah, my goodness.
Man, Ryan Rollins is just a smooth-looking freshman. Reminds me of Sammy Bajegas that used to play at Toledo.
Yeah, there you go. Digging deep now.
Sammy had a little problem after his career.
Sagoo squared it up. Missed it short. And the rebound for Milner and Toledo. Milner to the rim, attacking on Hardnett for two.
Man, that was something right there. Keith Triplett-like as he went to the rim.
By the way, we gave a lot of love to Toledo earlier. Buffalo's a great city, too. They got some Triple-A baseball. They got the Bills playing great football now. It's a shoulder dropped by Mbala on an offensive foul.
Yeah, but I'll say this. If Frank Reich didn't screw up the game against the Bills. The Bills would have been out in the first round. That's really good defense right there. Just take a charge and you're all good.
You can't help yourself with the Colt stuff.
I mean, I hear all these guys on TV and the morning shows on ESPN and others talking about Frank Reich as a elite coach. Go watch the Bills game. Go for it on fourth and four.
Hey, don't be saying that in a Buffalo game. They love Frank Reich there, okay?
They should. Frank Reich, Thurman Thomas,
Carwell Gardner. Now everybody likes me
Joe Stasiak. They should like him more because of how he coached in that game. They should love him because of how he coached the next playoff game.
Nice spin. Down to 30 seconds in this first half. Marion Jackson.
Look at this for three. So I told you, Jason, early in this game, Buffalo should have been up 8-10. Toledo was missing shots, not rebounding on the defensive end. You let a team do this like Toledo, they're going to unload on you.
13-2 run for Toledo. They've got 7 threes in the half, and now Graves with the shot clock off against Littleson, who's right there with him. That is great defense to end the half for Littleson and Toledo.
Boy, that was terrific. That was a bad, bad offensive possession. You just stood out there and dribbled, and frankly, they picked on the wrong guy. Graves trying to pick on Littleson. Littleson sat down, Jason, and took Graves out of any chance to make a bucket.
40-32, Toledo at halftime. Sean Farnham and the proprietor of the mid-major top 10. Kevin Connor is in all his glory at halftime now. Halftime in the All-America City. It is Terry Gross's Buffalo Bulls trailing Lee Ross Dockage's Toledo Rockets 40-32. It's show and tell time with Dan.
Yeah, this is my wife Lee. Took Toledo, the only MAC softball team ever to go to the College World Series. My wife was an All-American. I'm very proud of my wife, Lee Ross Dockage.
She's awesome. I don't know how she puts up with you, but she is awesome.
I don't know.
You just lean too close to the camera with how shiny you are, by the way. Toledo's shooting threes and blazing trails.
This one started right there. That's the one that got him going. And you know what? Toledo hasn't stopped. Sonder has been absolutely great. And then it started. 7 of 13. A lot of different guys. A lot of different ways. And I'm telling you, they're capable of continuing this. On the other side, you know what? Driving the ball has been okay. Certainly early taking the ball to the rim. But you're going to have to combine it if you're Buffalo with some made threes and some better ball handling. The ball handling for Buffalo was not great at the end of the half. And next thing you know, they're down 8, but that was sweet.
Look, their game all game has been rebounding. Offensive glass, rebound, and drive. They're plus 12 on the boards. But Toledo is such a good three-point shooting team. Buffalo is a top 5 three-point shooting defense, but they've not been able to push Toledo off the line tonight.
No, and they've been late getting there in a couple different help side situations, which is kind of tough.
JT Shoemate had it knocked free, and here comes Graves and Buffalo with a pull-up pass to start this second half. So Buffalo with four guys getting at least 13 points a game in their starting lineup. Williams had it poked away, and Marion Jackson.
Yeah, Jackson really made a good play there.
This rebound is out of bounds. They got a push against Buffalo. We said in the first half, Dan, Marion Jackson has a lot of pride in this game, and he wants to beat Buffalo for the first time in 6 tries.
Well, look, you play guys twice, once, and you play, maybe you play them again in the tournament. You got bad memories when you're beat that many times, and you know, for athletes, guys that are real competitors, man, keeps them up. It does. You target certain teams. You got to feel good going home.
Slip and Milner traveled. Yeah, he did.
It's the most miserable drive. I'm just going to tell you, in the middle of winter, from Bowling Green or from Toledo, across the turnpike to Buffalo, it's horrible. And 10 times worse if you lose.
Why is it so bad? Come on, Buffalo's wonderful.
Do you know the weather between there? You know, I mean, I love Buffalo. Buffalo's great.
Yeah.
But it is such an awful drive home if you lose.
I've made the drive before. That's out of bounds. It's going to be Buffalo basketball. It's always snowing.
We had a driver named Sonny. who said, you're going to see the drive here, pretty good defense in recovery, and then just couldn't corral the ball. But Sonny told me before the game, I used to have Sonny sit on our bench. I'm like, he goes, Coach, no overtime. I go, what do you mean? He goes, no, we can't go to overtime or we're going to get caught in this storm. I can get you home if we don't go to overtime.
So you're just going to, like, foul?
Hey, two-point game. We ended up winning the game pretty handily, but if it was a two-point game, we were shooting a three. Can't get stuck for weeks. It's true.
So Sonny affected the game.
Yeah, he would have. Yeah. We won the game. We called no timeouts in the last 10 minutes because even if they made a run. And I looked at Sonny. He goes, Coach, we got to go. I'm like, all right, let's go.
That's awesome.
It's true.
Oh,
love that,
I love
man,
it.
Sonny.
Littleson, Shoemate, power dribble, got it, and a foul.
Boy, that was good patience. We haven't said Shoemate's name too much here today. Kid averaging 12 and a half, 4.5 rebounds, but tell you what, they went into him and he missed one. Now watch the patience here. He's got it, shoot, takes his time. Best jump on the rim, not much defense once he took his time and gets a three-point play opportunity.
Came from Walsh University, and his initial impact on the team was to be as loud as possible on the bench, he said. He wanted people to think he was insane. So he started to whoop up the bench, and now he's getting them, as you said, about 13 points a game as Buffalo gets inside again and cuts it to 9 with Janathan Williams.
You know who the most famous coach ever at Walsh University is?
Who's that, Dan?
Bob Huggins.
How about that? And Bala steps through and gets fouled. He'll get 2 shots. Texas Tech transfer. What are you laughing at?
Our boss, David Seisler, Lee's headed for sainthood.
Yeah, I'm telling you, you are a tough live. I don't know how she does it. You know, people say, like, oh, you're fun to hang out with. You're a good hang. You're a tough live.
You wanted us to have late kid.
Yeah, I did. I did. I thought late kid might be a good idea. And Bala got the first free throw. You can see his former team at 2 Eastern on ESPN tomorrow against Kansas. Anytime you stray from the conversation, it's good to sneak a promo in. It evens things out.
Taking Kansas. We were on Zoom with Bill Self, and you can see in his eyes, he believes his team's pretty good now. Not great, obviously, early. Not Kansas standards, obviously, but I looking at Bill, man, don't sleep on the Jayhawks.
Was that for World's Greatest Podcast, by the way?
It was. Courtside with Greenberg and Dockers. Good defense. Give it up.
And Bala to Segu, flaring to the corner. Boy, great work by Shoemate to get out on him and wall him off.
Yeah, Shoemate hasn't done a whole lot in terms of scoring, but he's been really active and very good to start this second half. And I think a lot of it was his coach went to him offensively. Look, right there, walls him off, uses the baseline, doesn't foul.
Nice kicks, by the way, those yellow shoes. Good look. Down low, Williams spinning again. Janathan Williams, a star from Rochester, down the road a piece, makes it a 5-point game.
Second time they've ran a little back screen out of an inbounds for Williams, and Toledo, frankly, has just been lost. And out of bounds is something for coaches know this. You go over and over, whether you're in a hotel, whether you're at a shoot around, you go over out of bounds underneath.
Oh, Rollins was denied at the rim by Hardnett. Milner rims it out for 3. There's some of that side spin for you. And Mbala the rebound. Hardnett scores. You heard Toledo saying stay down. They did, but he still put it in.
Yeah, that was really good by Hardnett. He took his time again. Same thing I was talking about on the other end with Shoemate. He took his time, showed the ball. Strong. I've never seen a team, and I told you why in the first half, because a lot of their shooters shoot with a global spin. But I have never seen a team have so many shots go in and out, as deep as they go in, too.
Littleson, corner 3.
Hey, we call it clicking your heels. You let Littleson click his heels, 3.
He's a top 25 three-point shooter in the country. Graves the miss. Toledo and Littleson the rebound.
Remember first half, I said don't sell it.
That was an absolute blast at the rim by Milner.
Yeah, this thing go in and out. Huh. Man, he dunked on everyone. Josh Allen, Bruce Smith, Thurman Thomas. The place with the...
UBA understands how to play together.
And the question is, will the real Duke team stand up? Duke in Virginia, this is great.
Virginia Duke, Saturday, 8 Eastern time from Cameron Indoor. Man, Virginia just seems to figure it out in conference play. They're doing it again. They're top 7 in the country. Houston took a header, obviously, last night. But, I mean, Virginia's carrying the torch for the ACC right now.
They shoot it. They're always going to guard it. I'm really anxious to see what happens in this Duke game because I like Duke. Hey, look, Jalen Johnson, good for you. Duke has played better without him. Big win. You could say it's just Wake Forest. Let me tell you something. If you've coached, you know road wins, birth of children, and weddings are the three great days in your life. I don't care whether it was just Wake Forest. Without Jalen Johnson, they've played much, much better.
Before I get to that, there was a technical foul going to the break against Rollins. So technical foul against Toledo as Segu will go to the free throw line here. I said to you on your radio show last week that I thought Duke was a better team than Carolina, and you scoffed at me. Then Carolina went and beat Duke. You buying it now? A week later?
No, but I am buying that Carolina's guards are shooting it a little better, and their bigs are very, very good. I told you, if you're going to ask me Duke, Carolina, Kansas, and Michigan State, who's got to make a run, I would go Kansas, North Carolina, and Duke. Like, I think those two are interesting. Not great, but interesting, and I just don't think Michigan State has enough. I mean, you can have John Wooden, Bobby Knight, John Thompson in their primes, and they're not getting that team any better.
Well, we're going to talk about it tomorrow at noon Eastern time. We got Michigan State and Indiana to start our basic quintuple header on Saturday night on ESPN. But Joshua Langford, as there's a three for Harden at Langford, not the same guy, obviously. And there's a little bit of a Michigan State connection here. Todd Kowalczyk, the Toledo head coach, got recruited by Tom Izzo to Northern Michigan as a junior in high school. Izzo took the job with Judd Heathcote, and then Kowalczyk ended up at Minnesota Duluth.
And Todd worked for Tom Crean, who obviously worked for Coach Izzo for a long time.
Tom Crean, best known for being my analyst partner at a game in Iowa City a couple of years ago. Best known.
Sure, that's what he says.
Segu thought about the three for the tie, instead just sort of loped into the lane. Now they play volleyball. Right at the end line, and Bala wanted to create a foul. Bala scissors through and makes it 2 and a foul. Ridiculous.
Jason, you and I talked about him before the game, how much we love watching this kid play, and this is why. Hey, he's not whining about a foul. You know what he's doing? He's getting tougher, meaner, stronger as the contact comes. Man, I wish more kids would do that. He wasn't flopping. He was just balling.
He's a perfect example of why the transfer rule is good sometimes. He couldn't break the rotation at Texas Tech, and you wonder when you watch him there how that didn't happen, because that looks like a Chris Beard kind of guy. But sometimes you go somewhere else, you find yourself, and he's done that at Buffalo.
Look, transfer rule's great. You know, I'm one of those that just based on experience, people that I've coached have said the best year of their career was when they sat out academically, socially, and it's years after, but hey, transfer year's good. I'd be a hypocrite if I said it wasn't. My own son did.
Pull it out of bounds. And Buffalo will have it. That technical foul, by the way, was for taunting against the freshman Rollins. He wasn't the one that dunked. Watch.
Yeah, you can't do that. can't do that. You can't lean over a guy, particularly when it wasn't you. Usually I'm on the player's side in this. If you're the guy that dunked it, I feel like it's carte blanche because that's basketball, but you can't do that.
Yeah, that was superfluous, I think you could say. At the rim, good tangle, and Graves got into Shoemate. It'll be free throws for Javon Graves for Buffalo, who suddenly, after they saw Toledo go 16-2 to close the half, they're back in it.
You know, one of the things that I like about both of these teams, and this is something you can hear on TV, look at that bench for Buffalo. And then on the other end, watch the bench for Toledo. These guys are really good teammates, really encouraging their buddies. And that's not an easy thing. Yeah, you want to play, yeah. Right? I used to sit on the bench and root that Marty Simmons traveled so I can get in the game.
So you know bad teammates is what you're saying.
Yeah. In-game bad. I was in-game bad.
You were off-court good teammates?
Off-court great. Yeah, off-court best.
Tied at 48. Two winning his teams the max since 2013. Saunders had two fouls in the first half. Littleson always running around in a circle looking for a shot. There's a shot fake, and that wouldn't go down for Milner. And Mbala clears the rebound.
Boy, shot fake works in this game, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it should have done it there. Should do it here.
The FAA involved. As much flying by we got as Mbala had that go off his back. He somehow didn't travel, stayed
he
at the end
travel.
Line, and then threw it.
He got fouled, he traveled, he stepped out of bounds, and then he threw it away. And I love that official, didn't call any of them.
Three turnovers in one play, and
he
that
did.
Is well wide.
Scott Norwood.
I was just going to say, keep your Scott Norwood jokes, and you got in before I did. I can't believe you did that.
We don't
it's
need,
been
30
years.
Out. We hang out too often.
Yeah, we do.
Too much, too close. Hey, I'd like to see, if I'm Buffalo, I'd like to see somebody get the ball and go into the middle of the lane here instead of settling out like this. You know, it's what I was talking about earlier. You know, okay, the game is settled down. Now you need points. What's the easiest way to get points against Toledo? You drive it. You don't settle and jack up a three.
Jim Weitzel in his second season, the Lewis University Hall of Famer. Chicago area. In fact, we were talking to Jim Weitzel, and you have to like Jim Weitzel because he has, on his wife's side of the family, some White Sox fans. So we appreciate that.
That makes four.
Come on. It's a playoff team. Go away.
Well, if they can get somebody
Jackson.
At the top of the key that can shoot a three, they're going to get one.
Would find down low and rejected by the rim, Kamagou. People getting battered below the rim right now as Kamagou dropped the thunder.
Yeah, he did. Let's see here. Open, just dropped it down. See how he took too long, got off balance. Might have got pushed, probably did. But they're not calling it in here. Action is not for the faint of heart. And then here, Kamagou just... I don't know. Looks like he got the ball. No?
I thought maybe body. But yeah. I always say that just to
you
get
do.
Under your skin.
You do.
David Nickelberry off a career-high 14 in their win against Western Michigan. All right. Where was your favorite road city in the map?
My SID, J.D. Campbell, who is now at Indiana and has been there for a while, was the master of getting food on the road. And for whatever the reason, whenever we went to Akron, we stayed by the Outback and Chili's and whatever, and the feast in my room between me and J.D. was not mid-major. It was high, high major. So it was like going to Akron.
Wow. That was before all the food delivery services, by the way.
Yeah,
good job by you. Jackson missed. Buffalo's got the cavalry, and Segu rimmed it out.
I can tell you what the two most miserable were. Two most miserable, right, three most. DeKalb, Buffalo, and Mount Pleasant. That's great.
Fagan on the tip, and Buffalo suddenly's got 12 points in rapid-fire succession.
Yeah, that was really good. Fagan came in and just went to the backboard. Now we're just throwing the ball over our head.
Nickelberry on the bounce. Graves ricocheted back behind him, and they'll settle.
Okay, now, you said it. They settle, but they can't settle for a crazy three. See that Mac in the middle? Somebody's got to get into there.
It is Graves on the find, across the lane, and free throws for Hardnett coming. 12 in a row for Buffalo on the comeback trail against Toledo, trying to win a sixth in a row in this budding rivalry. You know, Buffalo's become the pride of the MAC. They've gone to the last two NCAA tournaments, winning the MAC tournament. And it's hard to believe that 30 years ago, they weren't a D1 program. 1987, Nelson Townsend becomes the athletic director at Buffalo. He's the first African-American athletic director at the university at Buffalo. And he was the guy that spearheaded their run from Division III to D1. His plan was called Run to Division I. And they did it in 4 years as Townsend was the athletic director. Passed away a couple of years ago, but a major founding father of this Buffalo program that's become great in basketball. It's been renowned for its football as well as MAC champions the last 2 years and four of the last five.
Yeah, he did a great job. I got to meet him a couple of different times, and what he did bringing Buffalo not only into Division I but into the MAC, and then he had to handle a terrible situation with the basketball program right in the middle, like literally a day before they were playing North Carolina, where, you know, there were allegations. They got rid of the coach. He called Erie Community College. The coach there was Reggie Witherspoon. Reggie came in and struggled for a year or two and just did an absolutely great, great job setting the stage for, you know, Danny Hurley and Nate Oates and the rest. Reggie did a great job.
Yeah, Reggie Witherspoon.
And I'm being literal here, Jason. Erie Community College right there. The next day, he's the head coach at Buffalo, and they got to play North Carolina.
By the way, Toledo's energy is basically gone. That was a lazy pass. Segu the lob, and it ends up in the Buffalo Bison's clubhouse.
Segu needs to watch this tape with someone that has enough confidence to rip him for silly decisions, because Segu is really good, like uber talented. He doesn't need to make decisions like that. They're too costly.
He's named after the soccer star Cristiano Ronaldo, by the way. Got a little bit of that flair in it.
Yeah.
A little bit. I know you're not a soccer guy, but I figured I'd drop it for the people who are. I know you're not.
Yeah, I am.
I know you're not.
Mm-hmm.
Rollins finds the ears on it and scores. It's a four-point game.
Well, that's just bad luck for Buffalo. They had the ball on the ground, played really good defense. I'm telling you, you come down in the break, you got a chance to really damage Toledo. You turn it over. Watch. I'm telling you, one play in basketball turns it around.
You feel it right now?
Yeah, I do. As much as I can feel it from Indianapolis, Indiana, I do. I thought that, you know what, you said it. The energy for Toledo was about ready to head south. The run was made by Buffalo without Williams. You're coming down on a break where you can just, you know, keep pounding and pounding, and next thing you know, you turn it over. A bucket, a stop. Now you got a chance for another bucket if you're Toledo.
Milner off the spin, wanted to get to the rim, and did.
Well, good defense, better offense. Milner was guarded heavy. Next thing you know, he just hooked it in.
See what Segu does here. He settled for the three earlier on a play like that. Now he gets to the rim and gives it up to Mbala, who nearly walked again. Keeps the motor going and rimmed it out.
Basketball gods, no.
That was a travel, wasn't it?
Twice.
Rollins didn't, certainly, and we got a foul called on a push against Buffalo.
You can feel it. You can feel it right now. Toledo is energized. And this kid, Rollins, is going to be a star. I mean, I'm talking about the kind of kid that averages 22, 23 points a game as he goes through his career. And if he's smart enough to stay at Toledo, he'll end up being one of the top 10 all-time scorers in the Toledo Rocket history. He's that kind of scorer.
What do you like so much?
He just has a smoothness about him and an ease with he shoots it. And as he gets stronger, he's got tremendous athletic ability. He'll get to the rim and finish. And, you know, you come in as a freshman and all of a sudden you're averaging 13. I mean, it's not that big a stretch to say he'll be in the top 10 because it'll be 15, 18, 22 if he's smart enough to stay.
Yeah, he's 25 and a half as a high school senior. There he goes again, front iron. But 20 points plus a game each of his last 3 years in high school is now Segul slow it down and smart enough to stay, meaning not get poached from another school as Segul scores.
You can see what Segul has. Yeah, it's not get poached because right now I'm telling you there are assistant coaches at high majors that are watching it and going, wait a second here. It's a dirty business, but it's the one that people want. They want kids to be able to transfer and lead programs like the MAC, and I think it stinks.
Oh! Milner was off the end line, and Littleson missed a three. I mean, he was using the baseline as an easy chair and spat it out for an open three.
I think the referee was right there. Let's see. The old over-the-head flip. You don't see it often. Yeah. Yeah, good call.
I think that was Bill Eck, if I know the back of the head well enough, and that's a really good call.
I think he threw me out twice.
You said three times during the break.
Yeah, I gave it some thought.
I think you might have given it some repression.
Yeah. Four by the time I go to sleep tonight, I've forgotten one.
Eight and change to go. Buffalo up by four. Toledo was up eight at halftime. And now Marion Jackson, who's been fairly quiet in the second half. Shoemate almost walked. Jackson pull up, got it for two, his first bucket of the second half.
Yeah, everybody touched it there, and everybody was a threat. That was good offense, really good offense. Todd Qualchek got his team to circle a little bit. Everybody touched, everybody was a threat. Nobody was just standing, looking.
Double on Mbala. Tough pass, rolled down the middle of the lane by Williams, and it got deflected.
Not a bad move when we come back. Doubling Mbala in the post. They're passing, they being Buffalo, very, very shaky. The more you make a pass, the more they're apt to turn it over.
A lot of passes going through hands and two other players. Buffalo still has a 2-point lead over the one seed right now, Toledo. Buffalo by two over Toledo at 12-3 in the MAC. And here's how Buffalo keeps score of hustle points, essentially. Dan, what do you think of this?
I think it's great. I think a lot of teams do this. Deflections are a big deal. And you say, why? What's the big deal? Well, you disrupt somebody's offense by getting your hand on the ball, even if you don't come up with a steal. Obviously, steals and blocks and rebounds and all that are big. But deflections are huge.
There's the blue collar award going to Mbala right now, who's at 354. I mean, this is a team that plays hard, and he's well clear of everybody else wearing 34 in blue.
I love the kid. I really like both of these teams. I think these teams are playing the modern way of college basketball. In fact, when you look at the SEC, this is what Nate Oates is doing at Alabama.
Turn it to Segu, who missed the three. And the rebound hits the deck. Buffalo had it for a second, and they do pick it up. Graves for three. Mbala somehow wrestles it away. I mean, he's playing one on three, Dan.
Yes, he really is, and he's winning.
Segu almost double dribbled, got rid of it. That's going to be a tie-up.
That's what you're talking about, Jason, right here, right?
Yeah, one
of these guys. Look at all these guys around him.
I mean, he
Watson
got it against.
The gate here.
Yeah, he got the rebound against three guys, then he went back into three guys. Shot clock goes off, and that should be a violation.
This is the greatest officiated game ever.
Are you just trying to make up for last week when your mom said you were too contentious?
My mom said I was too negative last week at halftime. I straightened up, but no, they're letting them play. They're actually kind of calling it right on both ends. I mean, that's all, you know, you hear coaches say it all the time. Just call it on both ends, and they are. They're letting them play.
We have 18 total fouls in this game, Dan. 18.
It's 16 too many. I'll give you one each.
Marion Jackson, the senior out of Cleveland. Wraps around. Open look for Saunders. Didn't take it. Extra pass and a foul with one on the shot clock. Okunso to the free throw line.
Boy, you can hear the bench calling it out, right? I mean, what a big help. And Shumate just barely. Was that Okunso? Yeah, I'm sorry.
You like that foul?
I'm not bashing the refs. I think they're doing a great job. If you missed one, you missed one.
Wow. What's that in the rearview mirror? Is that a corner that was turned? As Okunso hits the free throw.
I'm not used to Todd Kowalczyk with gray hair. I've known him a long time, and he's always had the best hair. Now I see him. Coaching has made Todd Kowalczyk get gray hair, and I don't like it.
That is top-notch hair, though.
It's great hair.
Free throw good. We're tied. Okunso makes it 56 all. Lower scoring game than we expected tonight. And we'll see if Buffalo can win its sixth in a row in the series against Toledo.
Got to play inside out. You can shoot the three. That's great, but you got to go inside out. Somebody got to get to that Mac right there.
Sigu. Found an opening and rimmed it out, but Toledo's Okunso couldn't squeeze the rebound.
You'll take that if you're Buffalo, because you penetrated, you kicked it, you made Toledo guard, and you know what? You'll take it if you're Toledo, because Sigu isn't making anything. And if you got to have anybody shoot it, might as well be Sigu. I'd like to see, if I'm Buffalo, I'd like to see Williams get involved with the basketball mid-post.
Yeah, Williams been pretty quiet in the second half. Janathan Williams has only 4 after 12 in the first half. This is Graves. Now Williams halfway through the shot clock against Littleson, who's been a very willing defender. Williams still beat him.
Well, Williams best player on the court. You know, legendary offensive mind. Tom Moore in the NFL. He didn't coin it, but he's the first guy I heard say it. Players not plays late in the game. Williams, player. Doesn't matter what you run. Run something. Don't care. Get it to Williams.
Rollins, the freshman. Milner, the drive. Lost out of bounds. Whose ball? They're going to talk it over. And it's going to stay Toledo ball. The far side official, who had the worst view of it, is going to point to Toledo, 4 on the shot clock.
I thought the guy in the low part of the screen had a good look. And Bala really moved his feet. Watch, he keeps moving. I don't know how you can miss that one. Don't make me change my mind, guys.
I knew it. I knew it when the call happened. I was like, man, that's too bad for Dan. Here is Milner. Quick hop. He didn't get that off,
oh,
I don't believe.
Yes, he did. They called a foul.
Wow.
The reaching by Mbala.
I still don't think he got the shot off in time. Look.
It was the reach.
Guess so.
Bill Eck right there had a great look, but that is a bad break in a two-point game for Buffalo, not getting that ball when Mbala forced a turnover.
That's a good call, too. Watching it again?
Yeah.
Good call.
Every team could use that kid, Mbala. Every team, because I guarantee he does the same thing in practice, too.
Oh, he's got to be a bear to practice against,
yeah,
every day. 1 for 2 for Cedric Milner Jr., and now Buffalo by 1.
Williams, number 11.
There he is against Littleson, and a foul against Littleson. Man, Dan, have you seen somebody play 40 minutes or the, you know, full game for whatever he's played of defense like Littleson has tonight?
He's been really good. I mean, you know what he's done, Jason? Okay, they call a foul there. What are you going to do? You know, you're hanging on. You got a little hook on him. But did you see the position? He was moving Williams out. Now, what he's got to do, Jason, is not foul. Same thing. Just don't hook, and you'll get Williams off the block, which is exactly what you got to do. Littleson's been good on the perimeter as well. He's moved his feet, kept guys in front. It's a great game.
Janathan Williams missed that second one short. Now Toledo trailing by two off the Shoemate rebound, moving to 5.5 to go in a budding rivalry in the MAC, just the 30th meeting all time between Toledo and Buffalo. Milner baseline! He was not going to be stopped.
I thought maybe he was going to kick it, Jason, and he just put the brakes on, gave a great jump. Watch his jump, right? Boom! Best jump. Chin on the rim. You want to play basketball, any level, in college, in high school, learn to make your best jump around the rim. Jump up. High jump. Don't broad jump.
So vertical, not horizontal, basically.
Yes.
What you're saying.
Yes.
Great game tonight. Friday night action once again. 59 all, moving down to 5 minutes. And that two for Graves gives Buffalo the lead back.
You know what Graves is? You remember the name Harold Archambault way back for like Weber State or one of
Harold Arsenal. Yeah.
Harold Arsenal, yeah. He reminds me, strong. He can go in and play against anybody. He can go play in the Big Ten the way he plays.
They beat Carolina, right? Jackson for three. Toledo by one.
I like Jackson. I thought about it this time before coming down the court. If you're Buffalo, you are going to have to guard Jackson. He's got a look about him.
Segu had it smashed in the lane. Milner went up for it. And Marion Jackson told us he's sick of people saying Toledo's not tough enough, especially in a game like this. And there he goes to the rim, and he's got five in a row.
You can feel it. You can feel it here. He's ready. You better guard Jackson. You better guard the senior guard. If you lose him like you did right there, he'll hit three. If you can't keep him in front of you like he just did after that, he'll lay it in on you. Better guard him.
Oh, it's just constant all day tomorrow. Great college basketball. Saturday, 2 Eastern time, Texas Tech and Kansas in a rematch from earlier this year. Low-scoring game. We'll see where they get to tomorrow. And then Saturday, 8 Eastern time from Cameron. Number 7, Virginia on the road at Duke. I know you've loved Jay Huff for what amounts to 13 months now since you compared him to Anthony Davis when we had the Syracuse game back in January of 2020. As Toledo suddenly has a 3-point lead again, but Williams trying to bring Buffalo back.
Well, he's going to have to be the guy. We saw on the other end, Jackson was the guy, but Janathan Williams, stars shine late. They just have to. It's simply called Big Possums Walk Late. And this kid is a big possum. He's going to be really big. You got to get yourself a win at home against the best team in the league, which is Toledo.
Rockets by three. They've got 3 games left. They'll play Western Michigan at Central Michigan and then Ball State before the MAC tournament comes up. Marion Jackson challenged that and stole it. He's got 7 in a row for Toledo.
Well, that was awful in terms of setup out of bounds. One guy was moving, and when he was guarded, Segu, nobody came to the ball.
3 seconds!
Oh, line there, that was 3 seconds.
Everybody in the world on the Toledo bench yelling 3 seconds.
Nowhere to go.
Segu, too strong. Ambala follows. Too much again. Reload for Graves. And Ambala went over the back of Jackson, who comes up with a tie-up. Wow. That's fortunate for Ambala not to be called with a foul, but Marion Jackson looks like he's not going to lose this game tonight.
Sure does. That's exactly the best way you could put it, Jason. He looks like he ain't losing.
Last 7 points for Toledo, Dan, for the senior out of Cleveland, Marion Jackson.
He's been absolutely terrific. You said it. He has a look on him that he is not going to lose this game, and he's doing what a senior should do. And this kind of started it right here with the three. And then he went and whooped everybody to the rim, used his strength to get it up and in. And this is a bad setup on the inbounds. And, you know, from a coaching standpoint, you got to have more than one option because the freshman was not going to get open against a guy who is as big, not big, but strong and tough as Jackson.
You remember the samurai sketches on Saturday Night Live? Samurai dry cleaner, everything like that?
Yeah.
So the guy who wrote those, Alan Zweibel, is a Buffalo alum. And it feels like Marion Jackson would take the samurai to the rim right now.
He would. He, look, you got a 5-point lead, you got the ball, 3.5, you can't settle. You got to get something going to the rim. You know what? In this game, referees are calling fouls on this end when Toledo goes to the rim, so put him in a position to call a foul.
Milner got the screen. Missed the three. Jackson went up and couldn't feel the rebound.
Well, I'll tell you this. This is a big call. This would even it out if they give it to Buffalo because that's Toledo's ball.
I think Toledo just did get the call back. Watch again.
Ooh. One was a terrible call against Buffalo, and that one, not terrible, but not great.
Sounded like a British ambulance there for a moment with that sound you made. Rollins.
If Rollins gets a look, he's going to make it.
Shoemate with a shoulder in, too strong. And the rebound for Williams in Buffalo, 5-point game. Bulls trying to win their 6th in a row against Toledo and their 4th overall this season right now.
They're doubling off Graves on Williams. Graves is gonna have a shot if he drives it towards him.
Tagu's a very good shooter, but has not shot it well tonight. To the rim, no, Mbala goes over the back, shoves Shoemate, and there goes the shot clock.
How's that not a foul or a tie-up? What great defense. Shoemate did go straight up, right?
I think so.
But I thought it was a tie-up. I don't necessarily want a foul here, maybe there, but all right, watch this. Pushes him out of the way. Great defense, absolutely great defense by Toledo. Oh boy.
Littleson off the stack, drills the three. What a great play.
They ran a little double, kind of circled and popped the screener, one of which was Littleson, and he drilled it out of bounds.
Yep, turnover, Sagu, Toledo ball up 8.
Watch this setup, this is pretty nice. You can't kind of see it, but it ends up being a double screen with Jackson and Shoemate after Littleson was kind of in the middle of the mix. Now, if you are Buffalo, you have to have a stop. Get the ball down the court and take it to the rim. If you're Toledo, take your time. Don't settle for the first halfway decent three. Get a great look here, make or miss.
Toledo trying to break a tie at the top of the MAC after Akron won against Ball State tonight. Marion Jackson scores again. Wow. Every Friday night we see a guard take over a game in the MAC.
Nowhere to go.
And a foul on Milner.
Now remember, you said it. Really good free throw shooting team is Toledo.
78%, 78.5, that's 16th in the country. A top-ranked boxing Saturday night from Vegas, Miguel Burchell defends his WBC Junior Lightweight title against Oscar Valdez in the 12-round main event. Main card starts at 10 Eastern, 7 Pacific on ESPN. ESPN Deportes and the ESPN app. Prelims start 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific on ESPN Plus. Toledo breaks the press. And they're going to foul very early. They foul Rollins, who's a 79% free throw shooter. The only guy of the starters you'd ever want to foul is Milner, who's at about 66%. Freshman Rollins missed the front end.
Get a good shot, not a crazy shot. Put game pressure on him on the road.
Rave swerves to the rim, gets two. Timeout Buffalo with 70 seconds to go. Do not go anywhere. Why would you? It's a close game. We're back in 30 seconds. Just sit there. During the break, Dan's talking out all the options here. 1:10 to go. Toledo's got the ball. Do you foul right now?
Well, Toledo is a little shaky passing it, but, you know, nothing too bad. I would maybe trap a few if I were Coach Weitzel, and then I would foul. Now, you have one foul left where it's a 1-1, and that's where the most pressure comes. So if you can foul Milner, the worst foul shooter, get a trap here. I wouldn't foul him. He's not going to miss.
He roams all the way through the defense. Marion Jackson gets fouled here. He made his first 41 free throws of the season. He's a 92.8% free throw shooter on the year. That's ninth in the country in free throw percentage starting today. So yeah, don't foul him.
Betting's legal in Indiana. I bet he makes these two.
Yeah, I'm not taking that, Dokic. Marion Jackson got the first.
He doesn't hit the rim. Yeah, at some point you got to hit a three. If you can get a great look, fine, but going to the basket isn't bad business, just to keep road game pressure on Toledo if you can.
Oh, I missed the second one.
I lost a pizza.
Pony up. Graves to the rim, got two more. He's done it easily the last two possessions. Now they will foul Milner. Now, he's not a terrible free throw shooter,
no.
Cedric Milner Jr. He's a 66% foul shooter, and tonight he is 1-for-3.
Well, you got what you wanted, Jason. You had the 2 1-and-1s, and out of the four possible points, Toledo only made one. You got one. Now you got to pay the double bonus, and the thing about the double bonus is a guy like Milner or anybody relaxes more when you have two, not 1-and-1.
Got the first. You feel that? You
okay,
relax on two?
Fans. Oh, no question. No question about it. You know, it's subconscious. Sometimes it's conscious, but you definitely do.
Milner 2-for-2. Toledo opened the day an outright leader in the MAC. Akron won earlier to tie him. Graves, no. Rebound snatched by Milner, and he gave it up for Littleson. And Rollins is fouled on a wraparound, and he'll get two shots.
Tell you what, this is a great win for Toledo. I mean, a great win. To come on the road, hot team. Man, big time, and that's a nice ride home. Maybe you stop at Sparrow, I don't know.
Sparrow. Hey, Buffalo had a 14-0 run here in the second half, and Toledo weathered it, took it on the chin, and came back for a 9-point lead here with 44 seconds left.
Jackson just turned it on. The three that he hit, tremendous. Then he drove. He just got the whole thing going. He's just certain guys get you going.
Sagu threw it away, and we've got a hold, two free throws coming. And Toledo, we mentioned in the open, has not been to the NCAA tournament since 1980 when Dick Miller and Harvey Knuckles were playing for the Rockets.
Well, Stan Joplin, who coached at Toledo, hit the game winner in the first round to beat Iowa. It's a legendary. And Stan was a really good coach at Toledo, really good. He worked for Tom Izzo, and then he came here, and I thought he was a terrific coach. Bowling Green and Toledo. Bowling Green, 1968. I think about it all the time, how close we came. But you know what? Ultimately didn't get it done in Toledo. Northwest Ohio needs a team in the tournament.
Could be the year.
Yeah.
Could be the year.
Toledo's good. Really good. Tough.
Yeah, I if you're a Toledo's been hovering around like 13, 12 seed. You're a 4 or 5. You do not want to face the team that's a 38% three-point shooting outfit.
That's exactly right. That game in the first half went from what? Buffalo up 4-6. To all of a sudden, it was an 8-point game at half. I mean, quick too. Better foul here if you want to keep trying. Noon, join us, Benetti, Dockage, Indiana, Michigan State. Kid me?
Here's the great part. We got all the promos in tonight, and you just added a promo. I think we get bonus promo points.
Based on Twitter, I think the people in Buffalo love us, so there'll be a big Buffalo contingent watching that tomorrow on ESPN, I do believe.
Well, I know the great Duke McGuire was watching the telecast tonight, the longtime color analyst for the Buffalo Bisons, who is one of the greatest guys in human history. So glad
to
see
some
of
the.
Yeah, please.
My friend John Murphy. John Murphy's play-by-play voice of the Buffalo Bills. John comes on my show. John and John Beilein were great friends. Absolutely.
Is that
great
right?
Friends. Yeah, they, you know, John was from this area, Beilein. Our boss, David Seitzer, is going to bed, so we can say anything we want for the next 30 seconds if you want to.
Well, David was on the field for the Norwood Miss, by the way, he told us.
Yeah.
As you brought up so kindly to the Buffalo people earlier.
I'm a big Buffalo fan. I really am. I've had great times in Buffalo.
I love it
there. I was
here
when they did the never mind.
I was there a couple years ago. Sabres made the playoffs. Everybody was outside the ballpark honking, "Let's go Buffalo," in unison. It was awesome. Layup good for two. On Trayvon Fagan's two-footer. It's a 10-point game, and that's going to do it. Toledo is going to end the night again in first place all alone in the MAC at 13-3 in the league. And, Dan, it's always a pleasure to share MACtion on a Friday night with you and yours. Well,
they are celebrating at the Rocket Inn on Secourse Street. Downtown Toledo is jumping. You can see how big of a win that is, man. That is huge, and it's a good ride home.
80-70, the final score, as always. For Dan Dockage, I'm Jason Benetti, our entire wonderful crew. Friday Night MACtion comes to an end. And right now, highlights of all day and everything going on in sports. We call it SportsCenter. It's right now.